Detection of breast cancer by the smell of urine. Understanding the hormonal cycle for a better physical performance. Treatments to prolong fertility. Femtech is shaking up the world. Femtech is a technology sector focused on the needs of women. It includes all kinds of solutions and products, from apps, wearables, nutritional supplements, to cancer detection technologies. It also builds networks where women can talk about topics such as menstruation, pregnancy, or menopause. And it can lead to other services tailored to individual needs.
Tracking your period and planning your pregnancy by itself is great, but also if you can link that service to, let's say, an e-pharmacy, right, where women can access contraceptives or get telemedicine services like getting consultations from doctors and so on, that adds another layer of service and really ties the ecosystem together.
Today, Femtech innovations are on the rise, from sustainable menstrual underwear to health trackers that analyze data from the wearer's fingers. Total Femtech funding reached $16 billion in July 2022, a 15% increase in just 6 months' time. Pregnancy and nursing is the largest subsector, followed by reproductive health and contraception, and menstrual health. Today, women around the world are striving to better understand their bodies because that ultimately leads to a healthier life.
This kind of female awareness of the fact that our body is different, and in particular that our body is cyclical, both on monthly period and our entire life cycle, is becoming more and more apparent. In fact, the US soccer team, when they won the world championship, they actually trained in accordance to their menstrual cycle. And maybe that's why they won.
Although half of the world's population is female, the femtech industry has only recently begun to develop. In the past, women's health was underfunded and under-researched. Male doctors and scientists have historically dominated the health sector. Little has been tested or optimized for women, despite shocking information, the female body is different than men's. In fact, women in the US, for example, were actively excluded from clinical trials until 1993. Years later, the pandemic accelerated growth in digital health. And social media platforms have built networks where users talk openly about issues like endometriosis or postnatal post-traumatic stress disorder. According to a survey of founders and CEOs of femtech companies and organizations worldwide, 65% of respondents said that one of the biggest challenges and threats in the industry was the lack of investment.
The biggest hurdles for me when starting our femtech startup was just really making it clear why it's important, having a solid response to why it's important, so breaking it down to lots of especially investors, right? Lots of my investors especially have been male counterparts.
Another challenge will be protecting user data. Users have become more cautious as sensitive data can be sold to social media platforms for advertising purposes, as has been the case with some period tracking apps.
It's a massive challenge in the US. In Europe and UK, on other sides, the GDPR has been very strict. Of course, anytime you use a technology product and you input your data, you should absolutely do research in terms of where that data goes and what at least legal protections you have.
Though challenges remain, femtech is a fast-growing sector that is evolving healthcare. It is also a social movement in which women are in charge of their own bodies and well-being.
Women are the gateways to communities. The moment that we focus on women's health is really we're focusing on a family's health, also a community's health, and a nation's health.
Have you used any femtech products yet? Let us know.